from the home of the Angels for nearly a half century, there's a look inside Angels Stadium of Anaheim. Today, a contest from the NL West Division between the LA Dodgers and the San Diego Padres. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. So that'll bring in Mookie Betts, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Left side of the infield into the shift. Fielded cleanly, and the throw to first is in time, one gone. Next to hit is Corey Seager. Now the 1-1 pitch takes a pitch for strike number two. Darvish has compiled over 1,100 innings of work over his major league career and sports a respectable ERA just under 3.50. He pulls this one into right. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
That is good. The second baseman. Play.
At the plate now, Trey Turner. Strike two as the fastball is let go. Count remains 2-2. Seager, base runner at first with one out. And another foul ball. And again, he's unable to keep it fair, but he's putting together quite a battle at the plate.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
And that's in there. Base hit. Throw into third. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away.
The first baseman, Max.
To the plate now, Max Muncy. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Popped him up. Caratini waits on it. And that's the second out of the inning. Next, it'll be Will Smith.
That is good. The catcher.
Runners on first and third, two away. Fouled away. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now the 1-1 pitch. Swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. So bases are empty with one gone. And standing in now, the always dangerous third baseman, Manny Machado. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
One out, nobody on. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Try to hold back, but he won't be able to, as that's ruled a swing, and there are two away now.
That is good.
Bases are empty here with two away, and that'll bring up Jake Cronenworth. And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's 1-2.
Going to be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
Fouled off.
Hey, this guy's dialed in right now. Two strikeouts and still working ahead. This is going to be a tough test for the offense.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Still a ball and two strikes. Trying to strike out the side. Here it is. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. Second inning set to go, and digging in at the plate will be Justin Turner. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
I can't blame him one bit out on the mound. I'm shocked he didn't pick up the rosin bag and see if he could get a foul ball on that one. He had to see if he would swing way outside the zone.
And he'll indeed make the play in foul territory for the first down. Ready now is
A.J. Pollard.
Boy, he just threw that fastball by him. Drives it out to deep right center field. Long run for the right fielder, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. The batter will be Gavin Lux. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. The 1-1.
Count is 2-1.
He's up in the zone a lot right now. Sometimes that can be effective, but I think you have to be careful with that, especially during a day game where the ball tends to carry a lot more.
Count even at 2-2. Darvish pauses. Here comes the pitch. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. For the last half of the inning, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder Will Myers. The 2-1. To hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
It's a fine line for working down in the zone on 2-2 and bouncing one in there that basically stands no chance at getting swung at. Right there, he basically spiked that one right into the dirt, and now he has to find the zone on a 3-2 pitch.
A ball and two strikes now.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch outs and working on number five.
Ball, that pitch is out. And 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off speed pitch in the dirt.
Fastball is outside. It's full now, 3-2. Pulled toward right center field. Lux is underneath this one. And there's the second out of the inning. Stepping in next, Victor Caratini, trying to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. This ball will be chopped foul. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. Set to get underway, and that'll bring up one of the better hitting pitchers in Max Scherzer. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number two.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence, he's got great body language on the mound, he's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Here now the 2-2. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three. And it's fouled away. And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch till he proves he can lay off of it.
Liner toward right center, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
Now batting the shortstop, Corey Seager.
At the plate, Corey Seager. And it's 1-2.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
And he fouls this one off. Here's another 1-2. Line hard toward right center. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. And no sense risking anything here as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out. In now, Trey Turner. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Skied into straightaway right. Tatis is there. Let's see if they try it. Well, next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter. Max Muncy popped into foul ground his last time up.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit. You make the pitcher work the way he did right there, and that's the end result. That one sticks with you for a while.
Fouled away. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue.
I'll tell you right now, he let go of that one, and he wanted to pull it back. That was a hanger, bad spot over the heart of the plate. He's lucky. He's lucky that's getting sent back to him.
Another foul ball, and this battle will continue. Finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out. Stepping in once again is Will Smith. And a golden opportunity here to give his guys the lead with three men aboard. Swing and a miss on the cut fastball. 1-2.
Hey, this is a huge pitch right here. It would be demoralizing to watch this inning slip away.
2-2 to the Dodgers catcher.
I got to count. 2-2.
Stays alive, still 2-2. 2-2, here it is. Again, he sends it out of play. Swing and a high pop-up. Hosmer is there for it. He's got it, and that'll get him out of the jam. So now to the plate, Trent Grisham, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. Here's Scherzer now, 1-1. A ball and two strikes. swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out.
The second baseman.
One out now in the San Diego third, and that brings up Adam Frazier. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. On the ground to third. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Batting ninth, the pitcher,
standing in now,
Yu Darvish.
And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. To second for one. Throw to Muncy to finish the double play. That retires the side. Stepping in, Justin Turner comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
Oh, you have to love it. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low-scoring pitcher's duel for once.
One gone now in the Dodger fourth, and that'll bring up A.J. Pollock. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Two balls, one strike.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Tatis is in his tracks now, and that's out number two. And now in the box, Gavin Lux. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Darvish pauses, looking to put him away here on a ball and two strikes. Back up the middle, and the inning will continue as that's through for a two out hit. Into the box, Max Scherzer fouled off. Lux leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. Struck out in his first at bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. And oh, we can't get out of the way of that one. So the leadoff man will be on to open the frame.
Up next for the
so
ball.
Now into the box is the Manny Machado. Struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Machado.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And he'll get to see another one. It'll be the 10th pitch of this at-bat. The 3-2 one more time. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Now to the plate. Here is Jake Cronenworth. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Here's a little chopper up the middle. High hop, and he bare hands it. It's there, and he's out. Here's Will Myers. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
Number 5, Will Meyer.
Ready with the 2-1. Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 2-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Now Myers, a drive. This is to deep left field. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. At the plate now, Eric Hosmer. A ball and two strikes now. Struck him out, his 8th punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. So now here is Mookie Betts. He'll start off the 5th in this one. The 2-1 home. Taken, strike 2. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. And Tatis is there for route number 1. So one out and nobody aboard. Striding to the plate will be Corey Seager. Here's the 1-1.
We got 2 balls, 1 strike.
Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now 3-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
Full count now, 3-2. Turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. Ross Detweiler, the 6'5" left-hander, takes over on the mound now. Stepping in now, Trey Turner. Swing, and this is also hit well out to deep center. Grisham back to the track as he takes it for out number 2. So 2 out, nobody on, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. 1 run, 6 hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Still 1-2. Now here's the pitch. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Swung on and hammered. No doubt about this one. Watch it fly. And that one is gone. On a 2-strike count with 2 away in the inning. So now to the plate, Will Smith.
Nope, outside.
A little bit outside, 2-1. Grounded up the first baseline. Well, this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Now the pitch. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the 2nd time today, he's gone on strikes. bottom of the inning now, and digging in is the switch hitting catcher, Victor Caratini. And it's fouled away. It's a 2-2 count to the Padres catcher.
2-2.
And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Now it'll be Trent Grisham looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. And he fouls this one off. Here now the 2-2. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And it's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
So stepping in is Adam Frazier.
He's going.
Run one. In there. Now the throw. Not in time. He's in there at second. Fouled away. Two runs on two hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Soft liner to the right side. And that's in there. Base hit. He'll come home with it. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score. Jurickson Profar will be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with a runner at first and one gone in the inning. Good change of speeds, but he lays off 2-1.
You can really tell about how effective this guy's going to be when guys are swinging at that changeup. So far in this one, they've been real smart to let it go.
Profar ahead with a 3-1 count here. Lifted down the line and left. On the move is Pollock. And that will end up a foul ball. Payoff pitch home. Frazier leads off first with one away. And he lays off ball four. So he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done. Now to bat, Fernando Tatis Jr. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch. Ready with the 3-1.
Four-seam heater right down the middle. I would have thought he popped a clutch on that pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home. Oh, this ball is hammered out to deep center field. And it's gone.
Your attention, please.
New pitcher coming on now, and it's the former number one overall pick from 2007, David Price. In now, Manny Machado. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him, 1-2. Lays off, 2-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch. Fouled off. Another 2-2 offering.
Three balls.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces. Next, here is Jake Cronenworth. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. He's running. Offered at and missed. Here's the throw.
1-2.
And, in fact, there will be no throw as he loses the handle there on the transfer. The 1-2. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And he'll take this one to the bag for the out. But, meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Will Myers. He went deep for a two-run homer in his previous at-bat. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Turner there to put it away and finally put an end to the inning. Austin Adams takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the Padres. Number 53.
Now to the plate, Justin Turner. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. 3-1 pitch. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth. Into the box, A.J. Pollock flew out last time up. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Got to believe the pitcher's going to trust his defense right here. Look for something down in his zone to induce a ground ball double play.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Next, it'll be Gavin Lux. A hit in two tries so far. Now the 1-1 pitch is swung on and missed for strike number two.
Oh, I love that pitch right there. Up and in, jam sandwich.
And it's fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2. Turner stands at first with one out. And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone. Matt Beatty is going to come on as a pinch hitter now, so that means we've seen the last of David Price. Lays off the slider that time. 2-1.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
Taken, but that catches the inside part of the plate. Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Brustar Graterol enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 48.
Eric Hosmer to the plate now. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
The 2-2.
Looks to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
Lux is under it, one away. Next to bat will be Victor Caratini. Bases are empty, one man. All even now, 2-2. Again, another foul ball. Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. In the hit will be Trent Grisham. Over one with a run scored thus far. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And this will get through into right. And he's aboard with a single.
Now back, second baseman, Adam.
At the plate, Adam Frazier. Hit on the ground out to short. And that finds its way through for a base hit. Throw comes in quickly from left, so even on the hit and run, they'll hold things to first and second here.
Tommy Pham
will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Tommy Pham.
Set and the 2-1 pitch. Hit hard down the line, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Pierce Johnson is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 36.
Here. Seventh inning ready to roll, and that'll bring up Mookie Betts. The 2-1 home is looked at for ball three.
Well, that's ball three. The Dodgers right now would love to start this inning off with a walk anyway to get this leadoff guy on.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Back goes Grisham. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Here's Corey Seager. No career numbers to talk about for this matchup. One out, nobody on. And it's 1-2.
Hey, love the confidence in that pitch right there. Going right after one of the better hitters on this team. Not afraid to execute.
And he fouls this one off. Back up the middle. And that'll find its way into center field for a one-out hit. Into the box, Trey Turner. And he takes a called strike two. Tied him up there as this is softly hit down the line. The next 1-2 pitch. High in the air out towards shallow right. Tatis is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So the next to bat will be Max Muncy. Blasted a solo homer last time up.
Well, Matt, this is one of the problems. This guy's a good fastball, particularly low fastball hitter. It doesn't matter how hard or how low you throw it, that's right into this wheelhouse. What you want to do with this guy is move the ball from the belt up to get him to chase something that maybe he'll pop up in the infield.
Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. Takes a good swing, but this will be a foul ball.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Good swing just a little early, and he'll see another payoff pitch. Another full count pitch home. Fouled away. Seager is off of first with two away. He loses him on ball four. Next up, Will Smith. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. The 1-1 home misses for the second ball.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, tying run on deck, he should get something really good to hit right here in a 3-1 count. I'd be sitting on a fastball middle in.
And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
With runners on base, two outs and two strikes, this is a big next pitch for both sides.
And that's through for a base hit. One run is scored. And the second run will score as well. Nabil Chrismak trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. Oh. Standing in now, A.J. Pollard, fouled off. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Corey Knebel will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Cody Bellinger is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Ready with the 1-1. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2. And the knuckle curve freezes him as he becomes out number one. Here's Manny Machado now. 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far.
Machado.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes.
Two balls. Strike.
Oh, and he shoots this back into center field for a base hit.
The batter number 9. Shortstop.
Cronenworth.
At the plate now, Jake Cronenworth. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Runners off for second. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Here now the 2-2. Oh, this is hit to third. Will it be two? Oh, and it eats him up a bit. So here's Will Myers. It's head-to-head numbers against Corey Knebel. Not a big sample size, 0-for-1. Hit sharply but foul down the right side.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Lifted out towards straightaway center field. And Lux is under it to make the catch and retire the side. At the plate now is Gavin Lux. He went down on strikes last time up. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Myers is after it. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. So here is Cody Bellinger, and he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. The count now at 2-2. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan Devo, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
2-1 now to Mookie.
These are the moments that don't always show up on the highlight film right here. Big spot. They have a chance right here. This guy mixes in a knock. They have a chance to get right back in this game. If not, if he grounds into a double play, it's pretty much over.
The 3-1 pitch. And he misses again here. It's ball four. And that's back-to-back walks here with one away. So they'll go to the bullpen now, and it'll be the left-hander here to face the upcoming left-handed batter. Is laid off for ball two.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
That's in there. Base hit. Long throw to the plate. But not in time as the run scores and the lead is trimmed to one. So now to the plate, Trey Turner. 2-1 to count to Trey Turner. second. Did he get his double play? To second for one. On to Hosmer, but it'll come too late to get them both. Next to hit, Max Muncy. His career numbers in this matchup, not a big sample size, 0 for 1. 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
Full count now. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. Skied into straightaway right.
Tatis
is there to make the catch, and a great job of pitching as they strand the potential tying run at third. Joe Kelly is on the pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 17.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. And standing in, here's the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Long run for the center fielder. He's there and records the first down. Digging in, switch hitter, Victor Caratini. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. And the count will be full. Bases are empty, one man out. Sent on the ground out to second. Turner loves it. And there's out number 2. Next up is Trent Grisham. He singled earlier, making him 1-for-2 to this point. The 1-1.
Hey, this could be a huge momentum swing for this team right here. Relief pitcher has come busting through the gates and done his job. Try and get this team back in the dugout.
But we'll have to press pause as that strike 3 to retire the side. Mark Melanson comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Here now is Will Smith. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. Not cheated there as he takes a big hack, and it's 3-2. Lifted down the line and left. And foul. And he lays off ball 4. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
How about it?
Next to dig in, Justin Turner. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. Here's a high pop-up. Frazier has a play, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Chris Taylor will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Number 3.
And the 2-1. Down the left field line and deep, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. Here now the 2-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center.
Tatis
will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number 2. Digging in will be Gavin Lux. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. The 3-1 pitch. Here's a fly ball well hit. Right fielder looking up, still ranging back. And as Dodger fans have heard for years, she is out of here. To the plate now, Cody Bellinger. Started to go around there. Looked like he held up in time. No, strike 2, says the third base umpire. to 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Still even at 2-2. One run game here in the top of the ninth. And it's fouled away. And he fouls this one off. Melanson looks in. Here it is on 2-2. Fouled away. Hit hard to the right, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swings. Kenley Jansen, the man called on to close this one and earn a save in the ninth.
Number 74.
So here's Adam Frazier. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Bellinger is there, and that's not the start to the bottom of the ninth this crowd was hoping for. One away.
Number 16.
Digging in next, Jake Mariznick.
Mariznick.
The 1-1 home. It's a slider taken for a ball. Early, and now it's even at 2-2. Pitch on the way. And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now. Fans on their feet in a one-run ball game in the last of the ninth. That one misses badly. It's ball two. And that's taken for strike two, as now they're down to their final strike here this afternoon. San Diego down to their final strike. Oh, and here's a drive. Well hit out to straightaway center. Lux is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over.
Yeah, and that's just a punch to the gut of the home fans as they watch their team fall behind at the top of the ninth. Then they can't get it done at the bottom and come away with a loss.
And this afternoon's closes at a one-run game, 7-6 today. The Dodgers came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Joe Kelly gets the W on the mound. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon. For the victorious Dodgers, 7 runs, 11 hits, no errors, they left 11 men on base. For the Padres, 6 runs, 7 hits, no errors, they left 5 men on base. The winning pitcher is Joe Kelly. Credit the save to Kenley Jansen. The loss goes to Mark Melanson. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 39 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we